Hi everyone, this is Sagar here from the NB Group. Today, I wish to talk about a very rapidly growing trend I've seen in my city, Gurugram. The trend is the rise of builder flows. The resident of the city used to live in villas, then moved to apartment buildings and group housing societies in 2000s. And now from the last 3 to 4 years, they've preferred to live in builder flows. In fact, builder flows have the least number of inventory days among the three of them. That is, they sell faster than an apartment building or a villa. So let's discuss about this kind of residential unit, which is very crucial to both real estate buyers and real estate developers. First of all, what exactly is a builder flow? A builder flow apartment is a residential unit in a low-rise independent building. The building can have 2, 3, or 4 floors at max. After 2019, 4-story builder floors are the most common in Gurgaon, with car parking in still floor. These independent floors can be sold separately to different buyers, and the buyers will have proportionate ownership of the land underneath. These independent housing units are accessible through a common staircase or a common lift. The builder floors are generally constructed on smaller pieces of land, ranging from 180 square yards to up to 500 square yards. These units have a typical floor plan configuration of 2, 3 or 4 BHKs and even more in some cases. These units are developed as semi or fully furnished units, and people prefer to buy them as ready to move in properties instead of booking them in advance, as in the case of an apartment building. Living in builder floors come with a lot of benefits. First of all, you get one residential unit per floor, so privacy and a peaceful living experience is guaranteed. Another benefit is the ease of redesign and redecorating the floor, as a buyer will not have to seek permission from neighbors sharing the floor. Third benefit is the freedom from overly strict rules and regulations of RWAs. Residential associations of plotted residential area are generally less stringent and more accommodating than those of high-rise apartments. Another very important benefit is the low cost of maintenance. Builder floors have less amenities than high-rise buildings, so the maintenance cost is also low. This point also brings forward a slight disadvantage point of living in builder floors. These units don't come with amenities like pools, clubhouses, or community halls, the ones which you generally find in apartments. However, such amenities are readily available in metropolitans like Gurgaon. So it's not exactly that big a disadvantage. One of the most important reasons for this trend is the availability of ready-to-move-in options. At the same time, there is distrust towards real estate developers with respect to the delivery time of the high-rise projects and the quality of the final product. The increase in supply of builder floors got a major boost from the increase in floor area ratios, or FAR. FAR is the maximum permissible square feet of area which can be constructed over a piece of land. The increase in FAR has come in handy with increase in number of individual floor units which can be sold. In Gurugram, on a piece of plot, a maximum of 4 independent floors can be sold. So this increase in FAR and the permissibility of 4 floors to sell mean that the developers of builder floors can develop more covered area on a plot of land and sell it in a greater number of floors. So the economics of builder floors has also improved for the developers. Builder floors make sense for existing plot owners also. Imagine a joint family living happily together in a building. At the same time, the different nuclear families can maintain privacy while living on separate floors. This concept makes economic sense for existing plot owners also. The plot owner can do a joint venture with the developer, where the developer will construct the floors at his expense. In this arrangement, cost calculations are done, and the plot owner and the developer, they come towards a mutual understanding on which floors will be kept with whom, and in case of any monetary consideration has to be given to the plot owner from developer's side. In this way, plot owners can earn a handsome return and at the same time gain liquidity from the plot. Now, as the demand for builder floors has increased, so has the supply. Hence, it is important to keep in mind a few things while buying the builder floor. First thing to consider is the area in which the unit is present. Societies with proper gates and security guards, 24/7 power backup, wide roads, an ample amount of water supply, and presence of greenery in parks should be the topmost priority of the buyer. These qualities will help the buyer to live in a more peaceful, safe and spacious place. Another important thing is to check the title of the land on which the units are developed. There should be no encumbrance on the land, the paper chain should be clear, and there should be no dues pending against any government authority. Third thing is to keep in mind while buying a builder flow is to check the reputation of the builder. As the demand for these units have increased, a lot of unexperienced and unethical players have also entered into the business. Hence, one should do a thorough background check of a builder's past projects and make sure that he or she delivers high quality products. Thanks a lot guys for your time. I hope you liked the video. Please connect with me if you wish to know more about these units or wish to buy one of these or collaborate with us to develop some amazing builder flows. And don't forget to like, comment and share this video. And if you wish to know more about the Indian real estate and construction industry, then please subscribe to our YouTube channel. Thanks again for your time and have a great day ahead.